So verse 22, the purpose of the law is to make us all sinners. By the way, not in God's eyes. He doesn't need it. We're already sinners in God's eyes. That's why people died between Adam and Moses before the law was invented. People were still dying. Why? Because of sin. What the law shows us is sin in our own eyes. We recognize our sinfulness. In case we're of the sort with a hardened conscience, or in case we're of the sort that we're of a Pharisee bent, oh yeah, I've kept the law. Jesus sets us straight there, doesn't he? When he tells us that even your thought life is sin in God's eyes. You know, hatred, lust, all that stuff, that's as guilty as the actual acts. So the law shows me that I'm a sinner. Shows me my desperate situation before God. And it opens the door for faith to work. It opens the door for a Savior. I get concerned when I hear a Christian who is asked, what does it mean to be born again? What does it mean to become a Christian? What's that all about? How do you know you're born again? And the answer is something along the lines of this. Well, I gave my life to Jesus, and now I seek to live for him. Now, understand, I'm not saying that our salvation depends on our ability to accurately put into writing what happens when we're born again. I'm not saying that, and God knows our hearts. But just on the surface, what those words say, I gave my life to Jesus, and now I live for him, that's all works. That's all works. Where's the cross? Where's the resurrection? Where's sin? Where's Savior? How is that any different from someone says, I gave my life to Socrates and now I live for him? I gave my life to Confucius and now I live for him according to his precepts. There's no difference. It just brings Jesus down to the level of another moral teacher, huh? And that's how a lot of people view Christianity. Oh, they follow Jesus, the Jews follow Moses, the Muslims follow Muhammad, the Buddhists got their thing, the Hindus got their... That's not what Christianity is about. And that's not what it means to be born again. That's not how you become a Christian. Not by giving your life to Jesus and agreeing that you're going to live for him now on. The gospel is clear in the Bible. Jesus died for our sins and rose from the dead. And we must believe that. When we believe faith, God declares us righteous at that moment. This is why, in case you wonder, I don't do the altar calls and the hand raisings on Sunday. Nothing disrespectful to those churches and pastors who do. On the rarest occasions when I have, it's because, quite honestly, I felt a burden that someone needs to make a public profession in the crowd. But the reason I don't do that is I don't want there to be any possibility of misunderstanding where someone thinks, yeah, I got saved. Why? Because I raised my hand at church one Sunday, because I went forward at the altar call one Sunday, because I said the sinner's prayer one Sunday. No. The reason you got saved because Jesus died for your sins and he rose from the dead. And you believe that if you do. That's why. Some weeks we have someone, praise the Lord, who comes up to me after service and say, Steve, I want to receive Jesus Christ. And my first words are, you already have. And then I explain, I don't walk away and turn my back, but I explain what I mean by that. By the time you come up to the pastor and you say, I want to receive Jesus Christ, you already have. You're already born again. You already believe in your heart. That's the glorious gospel that we have. It's so wonderful. It's so incredible. What would happen if lightning struck as you were walking down to the pastor to tell him, I want to receive Christ? Would you go to hell? No. Because God sees your heart. He knows. But God also sees your heart if you are deceived in this area. And if you do think that your commitment to Jesus is what saves you, your desire to walk with him, because God help you when you fall. The first one in your ear is going to be the devil saying, I thought you were a Christian. Look at how you just failed your Lord and Savior. You must not be a believer after all, huh? And you're likely to say, I guess I'm not. Rather than run to the cross and just beg forgiveness and put yourself under that cleansing blood and just say, Lord, I blew it again. Forgive me. But I thank you for being my Savior. I know that my salvation is not based on my faithfulness, but your faithfulness alone, Lord. And I rest and trust in that. And I hope every one of you rests and trusts in that alone today. Let's pray.